I would first of all like to thank all the voters who had turned out and voted and given their mandate. I would especially like to thank all the voters who have voted in favor of the NPP, and some constituencies we won and some constituencies we lost. But that's the nature of politics. And what is important for us is to ensure that we accept it and we move forward. We got 11 seats. We had of course expected that we will get much more than that. But whatever the mandate is of the people, we accept that mandate, and we need to move forward now, and also do some post-mortem in terms of what are the areas maybe which went wrong, and work on improving them for the long run. So we accept the mandate, and we determine now to work harder to ensure that we can move further and strengthen the party overall in the Garo Hills. We had expected that we will cross the halfway mark. But we have seen that this has been a trend in the district council in the past also. Like in the last term in 2015, when the Congress was in power, they got 7 seats, and that time NPP got 10 plus seats. So similarly, this time also we're seeing a trend in that line, that even though we are in the power and the government, the numbers are not coming up to the level which we expected. There could be reasons like the anti-incumbency within the executive council, which is the GHEDC itself, and there could be many other factors that are there which we need to look at, and we will be studying those factors. But yes, we've seen this trend in the council for a very long time, but hope that in the coming months and years we'll be able to improve on the overall performance of the party. Tura has been a very tough fight. We got 8,300 votes, and the BJP got 8,800 votes, and they managed to win this particular seat constituency, which was very important for me personally also. But Tura is of course a very interesting constituency. Number one, because most of the employees who work in district council are from Tura. So therefore a large chunk of them vote. I presume that they have voted against the government in terms of the EC that was formed earlier by the NPP for not being able to pay salaries for 30 months. I presume also that there is also a factor that is there in terms of the younger voters that have come out and voted. So that has been one factor that is there. And there are some polling stations where the BJP has done far better than what was expected. So therefore, certain polling stations, they managed to do very well. So therefore, all these multiple factors are there. But having said that, we need to also see that are there any more other reasons for it? And it's important for us to learn from this experience and realize that we could do far better than what we're doing now. And it's a good overall result, a good experience for us. And the party is now geared up to ensure that we work much harder than what we were in the past, including myself. I also need to give more of my time to the organization and overall the constituency also. So therefore we need to accept it, and as I said, and we need to realize that there is a huge scope of improvement, and I'm happy and I respect the verdict that has been given by the people, and I will commit to continue working harder for my constituency and for the state as a whole. Yes, we have already been contacted by a number of the independents who are contested and won. We've also been contacted by other political parties and other members also. So we are in touch with them, and we are hopeful that we should be able to form the EC in this council, in the district council. But it has to be seen, because we are yet to meet. All of us have to meet together. So all the MDCs are busy with their constituency. But as soon as we meet and we discuss it, we're hopeful that the NPP-led EC will be formed in a coalition with other independents and other political parties.